Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video we want to give you a short overview about the Modbus Master Mapper Tool, which is available for our easYgen 3000 XD series, starting from software version 2.10. The intention of the Modbus Master Mapper is to enable our genset controllers, like easYgen, to act as a Modbus master device in a network. Control architectures are mostly designed as cascaded system. Here you can find different levels, where the different controllers are placed. Genset controllers are mostly placed in the network level. In the network level, the communication mainly is working as a peer-to-peer communication. From time to time, there is a PLC in the upper level. In this case, the genset controllers need to act as slave devices. As solar power is increasing more and more, also the solar inverters become smarter devices, which providing a lot of data to the system. This requires that typical slave devices now need to be masters to use this information for a more reliable and efficient usage of renewable power sources. The Modbus Master Mapper is a tool which enables several woodward devices to act as a Modbus master, which can communicate with up to 5 external devices. As a Modbus master, the easYgen is able to write to the devices in configurable rate groups, write Boolean or analog data, read from external devices, detect whether external devices are communicating, communicate to one selected device for test purposes. The installing process is very simple, just follow the pop-up menus. We want to show the functionality of the Modbus Master Mapper tool on an easYgen device, which communicates with a solar inverter. In this application, the load is fed by the solar inverter and the mains. In case of a mains failure, 3 gensets will take over the mains load as emergency gensets. The solar power will always take a part of the load. The easYgen is controlling the AC contactor and GB4. It also manages the solar inverter and supplies a maximum of solar power to the application. For this, it acts as a Modbus master in the application and receives data from the solar inverter. After setting the correct package, you need to define the slave by entering its IP address in the corresponding field of the device section. If you need more detailed information on the single section, please check out the help menu. Also the timeout, the Modbus ID and the port is defined here. In the rate group section, you can define different rate groups, which the easYgen uses to talk as a Modbus master to the slave devices. The write section defines the Modbus write command. The master will cyclically send a Modbus command 16, write multiple, to write data to the slave device. The list is always automatically sorted by 1, device, 2, rate, and 3, Modbus address. The read section defines the Modbus read command. The master will cyclically send a Modbus command 3, read, to read data from the slave device. The list is always automatically sorted by 1, device, 2, rate, and 3, Modbus address. Let's have a look at the available Modbus data of the slave device. We want to read out the total AC active power value. To have the active power value from the inverter available in the easYgen, we need to link Modbus address 53,235 to analog manger 55.04 INV active power of the easYgen. Now we will check if the data is read correctly from the inverter. For this, we are using our simulation tool. As already mentioned, we will use a simulation model of the easYgen. We will focus on the easYgen device, the inverter, and the AC contactor, which will be synchronized to the mains to supply a part of the load with power from the solar inverter. As all the needed measurement data from the inverter is now mapped to the easYgen, we are now able to synchronize the inverter to the mains and supply a load, which is defined by the power setpoint in the easYgen. When the easYgen receives a start command, the inverter is activated and ramped up to the rated values. When the rated values are reached, the AC contactor is closed and the inverter is loaded to the active power setpoint of 60 kilowatts. Let's check the setpoint screen to see if the desired power setpoint matches with the real value. This is shown as gen total power in the setpoint screen. The gen total power is the corresponding value to analog manager input variable 55.04, where we map the active power value from inverter Modbus address 53235. As we can see, the inverter is running with stable values at the desired power setpoint of 60 kilowatts. If you want to read out more than one slave, you need a licensed version of the Modbus Master Mapper. You can order item number 10017923 to get a licensed tool. The licensed version will support up to 5 slave devices. When you receive the license number for your software, you can enter the license key in the Help drop-down menu. A detailed description about the installation and a how-to of the Modbus Master Mapper is already available with application note B37919. You can find this and many other documentation on our QR code server. This is all for now. Please make sure to check our other video tutorials.